Are you kidding me? Is he really still asleep? Come on, Brian. Come on now. I thought you were asleep.
I literally just woke up.
It's game day. I was about to wake you up. 10 more hours to our game. Are you ready?
Hell yeah.
I've been waiting months for this game day today. It's 11 a.m. right now. Our game is at 9 p.m. So we got 10 more hours till our game, but I don't care. I've been counting down. I need to get back on that court. What is going on, you guys? Brandon here, aka Brawadis, and today I'm here with
FaZe Rug,
his real name. He goes by the name of Brian for those who don't know. But anyways, let's cut straight to the chase. So right now, actually in less than 1 hour, is our first basketball game. So for those of you who have been with me for the past couple months, you guys already know this. For those newer subscribers, I'll explain. So I play in this basketball league, and today's the first game because last season ended, my team didn't make the playoffs. In case you guys don't know, my team last season, no offense,
trash.
Brian, I was gonna say it nicer. They weren't that good. They texted me after the season and they said that they would love to have me on the team, but since the company that they all work at sponsors the team, they pay for it, I'm not allowed to play on that team anymore because I don't work with them. So I guess that was a blessing in disguise because I didn't really want to play with that team anymore. No, I actually did want to stay with the team just because I love challenges, and since the team was so bad, I wanted to play with them again to try to get them in the playoffs. So the second I found out I couldn't play with that same team, I started my own team. The first person I put on the team is Brian.
Let's go.
And then we got a few of our cousins. So this is going to be a much, much funner season than last year. Me and my brother playing on the same team, it makes it 10 times more exciting. So if you guys know me, I'm a competitor, Brian. What kills me inside? What kills me?
Losing.
Nothing freaking.
My brother will literally be in a bad mood for a week straight until the next game.
Guys,
we lose.
I hate losing. My passion for basketball is way too strong.
Okay, well, so we'll go 10-0 this season and win the championship.
That's a promise?
That's a promise.
So imagine how I felt last year when my team didn't make the playoffs. I've been itching to get on this court. So we've had a 1 month break from the second we didn't make the playoffs, 1 month until the new season started, which is today. This past month, I've just been literally like, really? We didn't make the playoffs? So we're about to play our first game today. Brand new season. Everything is starting over. Everything is starting fresh. We're 0-0. Brian, let's make a promise really quick.
We're going to take the W today.
No, not just today. 10-0. We're winning all 10 okay. games. 10
I'm
games.
I'm telling you guys, if my shot is on, it's over for them.
Anyways, guys, I was telling my brother earlier, last season, I actually ended up winning the MVP or the scoring title. I led the league in scoring. I scored more points than anybody else that season, and everybody was like, oh, you should be proud of yourself, you should be happy. But guess what? That scoring title doesn't mean shit to me if we didn't make the playoffs. So yeah, it was cool that I scored more points than anybody else, but I wanted to make the playoffs and that didn't happen. So I've been dying to get back on the court. Today's the day. I've been counting down the hours. If you follow me on Twitter, I've been tweeting every hour. Come on, let's get it. First game, new season. Let's do it. By the way, guys, last season you guys killed me. Every comment of every video, put Rogue on the team. We had no roster
spots. I'm here for you guys.
Yep, but like I said, now new team. The first thing I did was tell my brother, you're on the team. Who remembers prediction time during last season?
I remember.
Okay, Dad, prediction, win or loss?
First game, you guys are gonna win.
Win? By how much?
Seven.
Seven? Not bad. And how many points am I gonna score? And how many points is your boy Brian gonna score?
You guys got 10.
What? Okay, fine, go.
10, and Brian's gonna score 3, 6, 9, 12.
Woo! Oh, my dad?
He's going for 4 threes.
My dad hates me. My dad, he just put me with 10. Hold on, do you have any reason for this? Don't get me wrong, I respect everyone's opinion, but why only 10?
Because you're gonna have another shooter.
Okay, that's true. No, that's true. Last year I had no help on my team. This year, we do have help. So, okay, Dad.
Babe,
shout out to my girlfriend, guys. If it wasn't for her, you guys would be getting zero footage of all the games. She records all my games. She goes through the troubles of holding a camera for 45 minutes straight through all the timeouts, all the halftime, all the games. So, babe, thank you. If it wasn't for this beautiful camera woman, there would be no basketball game day vlogs.
Are you flirting with me?
Am I flirting with you? Did you catch me?
Yeah.
We need to go to the bank. We need to get money out because we have to pay, obviously, to play on the team. And then we're going to head over to courts. Babe, I can't wait. Wait, I was telling them what? Like, there's nothing I hate more than this.
Losing.
Like,
you
why
just hate losing. Because you're so good that you should be winning. Hey. If your average was 19 points a game, or guys, 19 points a game.
Guys, last season, I averaged 19 points a game, and my whole team in total averaged 30. So I would score 19, and then everybody else would only average 11 points. So I'm not gonna lie, it was nice to score a lot, but it was really frustrating scoring almost 20 points and then losing. Hopefully this season my teammates do much better. No pressure, Brian. No, guys, point in case, I'm just super passionate about basketball. Like, everybody who loves competitive sports loves to win. So yeah, guys, my dad actually made a good point that I didn't think about. Last year, I did average almost 20 points a game, but that's because I had no other shooters on my team. This season, I don't know if I'm gonna score that many points because we have more players on the team that actually shoot. We have more players on the team that could actually score. So I don't know if I'm gonna be averaging 19 points a game, but like I told my brother, I don't care how many points I score as long as we win. I could score 0 points the whole entire season and literally not even make one shot as long as we win. I really don't care. I'm a winner. I'd rather win games than score a lot of points. There are a lot of people who are the opposite, like, oh, give me the ball. I wanna score 30. I don't care if we win or lose. No, I'd rather win and just win the game. I could care less about my personal stats.
Oh. I predict that he's gonna have at least 15 points. So 15, babe.
Damn, people underestimating me today.
No, I'm gonna say 15 because now I have to put into factor you have other team players. And I think Brian, like, 5 today. He's a little nervous, so.
No.
He's really nervous.
Now that Brian's not here, guys, Brian was so nervous. He kept saying, okay, wait, Brandon, do you know which team we're playing? Can we go early so we can, like, stretch and warm up? Can we? Brian was so nervous.
He's freaking out. Oh my God, are you gonna kill me?
Okay, and do you predict we're gonna win or lose?
No, I predict a W. You're too determined today.
I'm so determined after missing the playoffs last season and waiting a whole month. Guys, I'm not one to make excuses, so don't take this the wrong way, but I'm just gonna throw it out there that my legs feel like jello. Like, I can barely even walk. I was in Phoenix all last week for a vacation, and I made everybody there that I was with play basketball every single day for how long?
Hours and hours.
Literally.
At like 1 in the morning.
I would make everybody that was on vacation only play basketball. Then I came back from Phoenix to San Diego. I played basketball at my gym on Saturday. I played basketball at the gym on Sunday. And I played basketball last night. So let's just say I played basketball for hours and hours every single day for like the past, I don't even know how long. So my legs are dead, but like I said, no excuses. Okay, guys, so we came to the bank to take out some money for the league. Like I said, you had to pay. But I just remembered, Jackie didn't stretch me out before the game. So your boy needs to be stretched out. I can't play without stretching, so we're just gonna lie down. Babe, how dirty is this?
Wait, babe, that's disgusting.
I know, but ball is life and I need to be stretched. Ow! Oh my God, okay, that's kind of too far back.
5, 6, 7.
Guys, one of my biggest regrets was taking my girlfriend courtside to an NBA game because she saw up close how all the trainers stretched out the professional athletes. So now she stretches me out the same way. And I, babe, okay. And I always have to remind her, babe, I am not a professional athlete. They are freaking pro athletes. I'm just a damn 21-year-old freaking kid from San Diego.
That's laying on the fucking floor right now.
Yeah, that's laying on the floor. And she always stretches me out super extreme. And she's like, well, I saw the trainers do it. And I'm like, I know, babe, but I am not a professional freaking thing. And you're not a professional. Ow, my back, babe. Just do it normal, please.
I'm trying.
Oh my God, my chicken ass legs. How ratchet are we? Wait, guys, I forgot to say one thing. You guys want to know how crazy I am? I play basketball way better when I'm mad. Like, for whatever reason, I play basketball way better when I'm angry, when I'm just super mad at something. I don't know if other people are able to play sports better when they're angry or not, but I'm just that way. So what I do is I try to make myself mad before a game, and sometimes, what do I tell you?
He's like, tell me a guy talked to you, or tell me, like, you cheated on me. Then he'll accuse me, so it's not even me telling him, he accuses me of cheating.
Guys, there were so many times last season where, so me and my girlfriend would be driving to the game, and I'd be like, babe, tell me you cheated on me. And she's like, what? I'm like, just tell me you fucking cheated on me really quick. And she'll tell me, and I'll be like, what? You cheated on me? And I'll just get myself mad, and I'll do really good during the game. So, babe, once the camera turns off, I'm gonna need you to make something up, so I don't know. Flirt with somebody, cheat on me, do something, because I need to win this game.
You're gonna burn my shit again.
And people think she's the crazy one in this relationship. No,
I'm the most calm person that you'll ever meet.
It's definitely me.
That's when they smile in my face. Know they wanna take my place. No need to pretend. She got a little bit of drama fresh. 1 month later, here we are. Finally. I'm telling you guys, I've been waiting for this moment. Ever since I found out we weren't making the playoffs, I was like, I can't wait till next season. My revenge. Oh, wait, guys. One last thing. Not only did I lead the league in scoring last season, but I also led the league in technical fouls. So I kind of need to cut down on the technical fouls this season. Oh, it's freezing. Oh, my gosh. All you shooters out there, you know what I'm talking about. When it's really cold outside and then you try to play and you try to shoot and your hands are literally frozen, I hate it. All you basketball players, all you shooters out there know what I'm talking about. The cold hands.
All right, we got our team here. Bro, what is?
Look at the shoes, hold on.
I don't know the Hardens.
I don't know if these are broken in yet, but I don't care. They're too sexy not to wear, so.
We got cheerleader Jackie right here. Alvin, Gilbert, Romson, Robert, and Chris.
Chris was my first ever coach when I was a kid. How old? Like 10 years old?
10.
We went 0-10. He traumatized me ever since I was a kid. We didn't win a single game. My first season ever playing basketball.
Damn.
But now he's good, so I must.
Yeah, now Brandon's good.
Right. Hey. I must have done something right.
Isn't this weird? Former player playing with an old coach.
I know, right?
11 years later.
Let's see if these Hardens are good luck. My first league game playing in the Hardens. I've never wore them in a game.
Look at the team getting you ready. What do I say? Babe! I like the white shoes better. With 8 minutes. 33 seconds left. Guys, I'm so surprised Brandon's even playing right now, because honestly, he played like so many hours of basketball that I don't know how his legs aren't like dead already. With 3:33 left.
Okay, listen, how the hell was this not a foul? In basketball, you have to give the shooter room to land. That means you cannot be under their landing space. You have to give the person who shoots the ball room to land. That's the rule. And that's beyond the fact that he slapped the shit out of my hand. Watch this again.
So 36-39 with 13 minutes left.
God. Seven with 7:36 left. 44:47. Left. 52 to 52 with 2:27 minutes left.
So I find that part pretty funny. So you know how in basketball, if you're down by two and that dude stole from me, so he had a wide open fast break. So what do? I fouled him because in basketball, if you're down by two and the other team has a wide open fast break with less than a minute left, that's what you do. You got to foul them hard. You got to make sure they don't get it up. So I fouled him and, you know, I went up to him after the play. I was like, yo, like, I had to do it. It's a foul. And he started crying. He was like, man, what the fuck? And he was like holding his neck. I'm like, bro, it's fucking basketball, so I found that pretty funny. It's a basketball move. You had to foul in that situation, so I fouled, and he started walking away with a pouty face, and he's like, man, what the fuck? And he was the only dude after the game that didn't give high fives to anybody. He got his stuff and just walked out. But watch this. I don't get what he was so butthurt about. That's proof that he doesn't play basketball or he doesn't watch any basketball, because that was a smart basketball move.
So supportive. 350. They ended 55 to 57.
Came from behind and hit me on the head. That's it. And I don't know why the fuck.
Damn.
Fucking rigged.
bullshit.
I got hit on the last fucking play.
Depressed.
Look, that's how fucking mad I am. If we lose the game as a team, I don't fucking care. But when a ref crosses the game, that's fucking bullshit.
You know what the ref said when I told him I got hit in the head? He's like, well, sorry. Wait, what was he? Did you see him at the free throw line? Talking to the guy. Remember, I looked at you and you said, what?
Yeah, no, what were you saying? I didn't hear
I didn't hear them, but he went up to him, he like whispered something to him, he gave him the ball, and they did that like twice during the game. The shit was weird, but yeah, I went up to the ref after the game and I was like, ref, I got hit in the head, really? And he's like, well, sorry. I was like, okay.
And we pay them for this? We pay. We each pay them for this. I hit 4 threes that second half. That's the only thing he could do. He hit me in the fucking head because I scored on the whole fucking game. That's it. And the ref didn't call that shit.
How about you? How do you feel? You used to coach him when he was little, right?
Yeah.
That's so cool.
It's a lot better now. A lot better.
Late calls too. Like, I don't care if it's a foul call, but the late calls after they already miss.
I don't know if you guys saw it, but the refs were talking to that light-skinned dude like the whole game. Yeah. Wait, how much did I had 20. I'm telling you guys, if we lose as a team, I don't care. Good job, good shit, we'll get him next time. But when we lose because of the refs, it's bullshit, I swear, I'm telling you. That's fucking dumb, bro. I'm furious, look at this. That's dumb as hell. Gilbert, if we lost just because our team played bad, this would have been me. Oh, good job, good game, we'll get him next time. But when we lose because of the refs, that's bullshit.
There was a lot of fouls that were called that were not on us.
And that last one mainly?
That guy jumped back in the head.
I hit 4 straight threes. I was going for that last three. He hit me in the head, no call. Oh well. Okay guys, now that I'm a little bit calmed down, I know I was really angry after the game. That just shows how much passion I have for basketball. I wanted to win so bad. Okay, listen.
Man.
We got screwed over by the refs. Yes, that's true. But at the end of the day, a loss is a loss. So we lost the game. I promise you guys we wouldn't lose any games.
9-1.
I promise you guys we wouldn't lose any games, but we did, so that's my fault. Yeah, a lot of people could blame the refs. There was some really bad calls by the refs, but at the end of the day, we lost. We're 0-1.
I didn't hear a whistle on the last play.
I know, but not when I get hit in the head, bro. I just couldn't believe I got hit, and the ref came up to me and said, well, sorry, like, really? But anyways, guys, you can blame the refs all you want. At the end of the day, a loss is a loss. We lost the game, so I can't keep complaining about the refs. So yeah, guys, that team was actually pretty good. They had that dude, that really long dude who was getting to the paint with ease. I don't know why he got mad when I fouled him that one play. That's a smart basketball play. And then you see he missed a free throw. So that was a smart basketball play. He got mad at the end. I'm really, really happy with my team. If you guys watched my basketball videos last season, my team was to be nice. Let's just say my team was not that good. And then this team, although we lost the first game, they showed a much better team than last season. So we should be fine. This is just the first game. Again, I apologize for my rant after the game. I just don't like when the refs cost us the game. Like I said a million times, if we lose just because we lost the game, that's perfectly fine with me. You can't win them all. Everybody loses games. But I just hate losing due to other reasons such as the refs. I still don't understand what the ref was telling that player when they were whispering to each other. I don't know. But I think I dropped 20 points. Shout out to my brother, Brian, who dropped 12 points. He hit 4 threes, so that was really cool. Shout out to Chris, my former coach, who was dominating inside the paint. And shout out to Jackie for recording the game, because holding a camera up for 45 minutes straight, going back and forth, trying to focus on the whole game isn't easy. So shout out to my girlfriend.
Yeah, I'm sorry, guys, if it's a little shaky. It's freezing.
Shout out to you fans who came to the game. I heard you guys supporting me. I heard you guys say, give it to Brandon, give it to Brandon. But anyways, guys, like I said, yeah, I dropped 20 points and that's cool and all, but I would have much rather won the game. We didn't win. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching this video. And to all my teammates watching this, I enjoyed playing with you guys because the experience I had last season playing with such a bad team was not fun. So this should be a fun season. And in my opinion, not only was it funner to play on, but I think it's much funner to watch the team. Last season, my team only averaged 30 points a game. And this season, we already scored 55 in the first game. So I think, and then obviously having Brian on my team, it's fun to play with my brother. So I think it's fun for me to play in, and it's also more exciting for you guys to watch. Thank you.
And guys, I'm really mad at myself. I'm really upset with myself because even though I got hit in the head, I feel like I should have made that last shot. So I apologize to my teammates. I feel like I let you guys down and I let myself down. I'm super mad at myself. I scored 20 points. I hit like 4 threes in a row, but I couldn't make the one that mattered most. So that makes me mad. I've never hit a game-winning shot in a game in my life, and that was my chance. Down by 2, last second shot, game-winning shot. And it came out, so fuck, I wish I made that shot. I'm so down on myself, I'm so mad at myself. Brian even came up to me after the game, he's like, it's okay. I'm like, no, it's fucking not. I should have made that last shot, but oh well, I'll take fault for this loss. I should have made that last shot. I don't care if I got hit or not, it should have went in. The ball should have went in, but it didn't, so I fucking suck.